process mining. My name is Oliver. I'm 42 years old. I'm married with Silke, and we have three wonderful children, Lukas 11 years, Tabea 9 years, and Fabian 5 years old. And I'm working for MLP since 1998. MLP is the leading independent consultant company, supported by comprehensive research. The group provides a holistic consulting approach that covers all economics and financial questions for private and corporate clients, as well as institutional investors. The key aspect of the consulting approach is the independencies from insurance companies, banks, and investment firms. The MLP Group manages total assets of around 25 billion euros and supports more than 800,000 private and 5,000 corporate and clients and employers. The financial services and the wealth management consulting company was founded in 1971 and holds a banking license. We as the IT department support through customized solutions and use standards and technologies, processes and outsourcing. This includes the implemented solutions from development processes, quality control and tests from the runtime environments for development and production environments. MLP is facing the same challenges as other IT departments everywhere, delivering excellent IT support for the business while keeping an eye on costs and demonstrating the value we deliver. As a bank, we have strong requirements from the regulation, BaFin, and the European Banking Authority. We are as IT consultants to support and advise our business departments, especially for IT changes and IT projects. We are the interface between the business department and our IT providers. The IT is nearly fully outsourced for run the bank and change the bank. Therefore, we have to regulate and control our IT outsourcing providers. The IT department provides services to the rest of the organization, which need to be designed, managed, and maintained. The governance part of the IT has to fulfill the business needs, as you see above, and evaluate them and direct them to the management. We love standards because we don't want to invent everything new, and it's a good base to work together with our IT service providers. In general, we use ITIL for RUM, CMMI and CMMI for acquisition for development, and the overall framework for governance and management IT processes are COBIT. Here you see a short overview about COBIT. Today I want to speak about our experience with process mining. I'm accountable for IT processes, for IT governance and IT compliance. Per year, we have many IT projects. We have 2,000 changes, IT changes, and we have thousands of questions and requests to our outsourced help desk. Coming from a one provider approach, we have now several providers, and they have to be managed by us. As a certified Six Sigma and Lean Green Belt, I support our IT and business departments to improve our IT processes. Six Sigma and Lean is perfect to support this, and process mining helps us to visualize the processes, the real processes. And 2 years ago, I started with change management from the SAP solution manager. And since March, I'm also accountable for the help desk. And this is a wonderful process through process mining. Very smart, very small, simple and easy. At least that was my opinion in March. This is the easy process, very easy. The green figures represents the MLT colleagues in the headquarters and in the 200 offices all over Germany. We can call the help desk or open a ticket in the web interface. And the white figures represent the IT outsourcing provider to handle the interaction. And in the best case, we close the interaction directly and help the user. Otherwise, they hand it over to the process's incident, change or request fulfillment. There are many benefits of applying process mining in the IT service area. One of them is that one can verify the compliance of the processes, whether they are actually being performed in the way they should be performed. The second one, in comparison to the auditors, we check all running instances of processes, and the auditors take most of the time only samples, only 50 or 100 samples, and with process mining we check all instances of the processes. The 4I principle is the third one, but there has to be the name of the employee in the log file, and in Germany it's not so easy because of the data privacy law. This is at the moment not in place, and we will see what will be possible in the future. A second benefit is that also on an implementation level, errors can be found. There are deadlocks in the process. Do we have long-term tickets in the system caused by technical errors? And do we have inconsistencies between different IT systems? They handle user requests, incidents and changes. For example, the incident is closed and the user interaction, the corresponding interaction is still open. Process mining can help us to show which of the paths are actually used. To reduce waste, it's a good idea to delete unused or unknown paths in the process. That makes the process small and simple, and it reduces efforts for testing and for new releases. Finally, the use case that is most interesting for me is that we can use process mining to regulate and control our IT outsourcing provider. And I want to tell you a bit more about this. As I said before, we are coming from a one provider approach. And what does this mean? That the process is handled by an outsourcing provider. There's a line between the company and the outsourcing provider. We are accountable for all IT processes, the definition and the control. For the daily work, the IT outsourcing provider is responsible. Some process activities are be done by MLP, because not all tasks can be outsourced, for example, the acceptance of testing activities. We have weekly show fixes with our IT service partner regarding the processes overall, And we discuss the service level agreement reports and if the outsourcing partner comes back with charts of everything is green, then in the past we basically have to believe them. But now we have process mining. The situation is different and more challenging because we have the full IT service management data not in-house and they need to be requested and paid for from our providers. In the future we have some new challenges. We have to manage several IT outsourcing providers and we have to manage several IT providers. And we have to manage them on the same IT processes. At the moment, that's not the state. This is basically the ground truth. There is no other way. We can double check the results at the moment. One basically has to believe that the process is followed and the key performance indicators are correct. The help desk user satisfaction, you see here the charts, is basically green. But what's about the compliance when the consultant calls me and what about the complaints directly to the management board? Something has to be wrong. I want to show now our approach where I regress the data from the outsourcing provider and how the data looks like and also tell you what was difficult about this. Multiple iterations were needed, data not direct accessible and we had to pay extra for these data. And I showed you the three iterations till now. But my vision was to start small and think big what we want to do with process mining. Here you see our IT service management tool and one incident. All data are there in the system and stored, but I started without the IT outsourcing provider. Via copy and paste, we collect the data from 100 user interactions manually, and I was really impressed. It was similar to our documented process on a high level, but it was not the same. What a surprise. I showed the result to my counterpart from the IT outsourcing provider, and we decided to go on. I did this approach also for the change management process. We use here the solution manager, but for all other IT service management tool, EMC Remedy, ServiceNow or LearnDesk, it should be also easy to collect data that is needed for process mining. Our second try was to request a report from the IT outsourcing provider with three attributes: the ID of the ticket, the timestamp with date and time, and the activity. And as I mentioned before, we have to pay for this report because this kind of report are not covered by our contract. A good business model. The next surprise: our service level agreements delivered by committed KPIs, but that's not the fully truth. And therefore, I want more data. The actual try, I expanded the report with several attributes, clone to and clone from, the related incident to the user interaction. Is this a call from MLP or from the provider? What is the impact, the urgency and the priority? Is the call from a very important person or not? And what is the class of the ticket, it's an incident, a user request or a complaint. Now we have the full data to analyze and improve our process, and we have the fantastic process mining tool. It's so easy to measure and show our possible improvements. Now you can see the easy process. Very easy, and I was really shocked. Because the documented process was so easy, and now we had this typical spaghetti diagram, nobody understands what happened in the process. The promised and nearly documented process could be represented with the tool settings, 50% activities and 50% passes. Now you can see the easy process, and lots of work had to be done. What are the summary benefits of this? Now we had the fully truth, and it was time to discuss this with the IT outsourcing provider. In the first meeting, they don't believe what process mining shows us. That's not possible, and the throughput times are not valid. But it was only the first impression. Now they also evaluate the process mining tool, and the discussion with the outsourcing provider is now based on facts, not on assumptions or on difficult reports. Process mining helps us to address these challenges by making the actual processes transparent, highlighting waste, and could be replaced the process document in future. It's one of my visions to replace statical process documentations with this technology. The key performance indicators at the moment for the help desk are more than 10 years old, based on prior requirements, and now we discuss together indicators measured via process management, for example, throughput times for very important persons and normal users. In the past, I worked with Excel and programmed very complex formulas to extract the data and comprehend the service level reports from our IT service providers. I had to analyze the throughput times in the Excel report, and then for each ticket number I wanted to know more about, I had to look up that individual ticket number in the IT service management tool to see the ticket history in detail. This was only practical for a limited time, a limited number of cases. With process mining, I can directly see the context and the detailed ticket history for all the analysis results. To 1998, we started with outsourcing, and 2009, nearly all IT members were outsourced, including application management and development, and the help desk for our headquarters. Now we started to work with more IT providers, and we have to change to define operational key performance indicators, not only for one big IT outsourcing providers, but also for all other IT providers. I plan to migrate all IT processes to the SAP Solution Manager, and every provider can adapt his IT service management tool with certified interfaces from SAP or use the SAP Solution Manager. And then we have a full transparency about our IT processes by using process mining and common processes for all IT providers. I'm a big supporter of process mining, and I'm happy to be here. Thank you, And special thanks to Anne and Christian for your support in the last 2 years and your invitation to this camp. Thank you.
We have time for some questions.
Yes, I wonder whether you have some concrete results on some, because you have done a lot of good work, I think, in controlling the system integrator. Yeah, but what has been the result? Did you have some reduction in the next contract negotiation? Do you have some concrete results? Because you just said yourself that you are, well, kind of green belt Six Sigma, so they put everything in figures. Do you have some kind of figure material on that?
Okay, the first thing was that we have the results that, for example, the throughput times for incidents and user interactions is in some cases too long. And we found some technical problems between the IT systems. The corresponding tickets from user interaction to incidents were kept. And we have to resolve this. We have fixed it. And we see on the one side many technical problems that now are solved. And now we have a good analysis and good data to discuss real key performance indicator. Early they were defined on how fast the helpdesk agents go on the phone. But we have no throughput times defined in general. And now we look over the whole process and go in the side of the users and not inside of the outsourcing partner and MLP at the IT department. But we can discuss this later. There are many results, but it's not so easy to fix some problems. Because what happened, you have to pay for this solution because it's the same stuff till 10 years.
Thank you. Well, one observation, I think that has been written in the stars that you work together with Disco, because if you just to put your logo and you turn it 180%.
Okay, thank you.
Otherwise, you can find him in the break and talk to him.